this is a bit of a different video. We will basically be going over the plans moving forward for after the bowl game. Going over like recruiting, like who's leaving, who's getting replaced. Russell, he was an All-American, so he was not awful. Rutgers didn't really get an opportunity. I'm sorry about it, basically. Chris King's probably gonna be our running back, star running back, our featured back next year. Hopefully, he can get a boost. But yeah, we have replacements for these two guys. Antoine Williams. Matt Nelson. Who did I reach? He's gonna be coming back for his senior year. Along with Mayfield. Yes, we're gonna have the equivalent of the Twin Towers for one more year. We have his replacement. We have his replacement. Mark Cook's being back for another year. Terrell Morrow has at least one more year. One more year. Yo, Smith. I don't think it's gonna be anything too special, but yo, we're set for like the next year. If he declares for the draft, then Palm will take his spot. Blake Bart will probably take his spot, assuming he's for sure going to the draft. Assuming Andy Martin decides to go to leave. Ellis could be back for another year. Morris is definitely gone. We're gonna have to go 100% to make Ellis stay. He needs to stay. We're gonna get Finley too. He's gonna be a beast. We don't have another. Oh, we do, but it's Jeff Webster. He's awful. Caleb Washington will be able to. Caleb Washington and Lloyd will take Weiss's spot, probably. Or they will fight for in training camp. Okay. Jay Moss will be the man if Corey Hunter decides to go to the draft. It's possible. they McDougal could declare. I don't think Carey will declare. Byron can't, too young. And Moody, he will get a larger role. James King. Yeah, we have Brett Lindley. So, if James King decides to declare for the draft, we have someone. And Gibbs is a freshman. He's had an incredible season. He's a freshman All-American. Okay, we'll find the punter where we have someone coming next year. So that leaves the holes at running back, receiver, and I've never been that good at recruiting linebackers. I don't know why. Never really been that good at it. Davis can fit. Can probably fit one of the two running back spots. But he'll be more like a power. He's definitely a power back. Or a quarterback. Now this guy's more of a wide receiver. But we'll probably play Eric Bailey at quarterback. Or if it comes to the worst, then DB. I mean, he has good hands. Deep. Not an awful tackler. Gary Moore will be a running back, obviously. Reggie Talbot, running back. We have a center. Probably moving the guard. Personally, I thought we should have made the natty. Dorsey, hopefully he's not to play. Hopefully he's not to play year one. And Holmes is the safety net in case someone decides to go to the draft. And Randy Connolly, he looks like he's a running back. He's a running back slash wide receiver. No, there's no question, you are a wide receiver. Really good backs, at least. Anyway, I don't know what we're gonna do with Fields. Jim Presley. I don't know what we're gonna do with Jim Presley either. I mean, if we get him, then. Justin Fields, if we don't get him, it's not the worst thing in the world. He's from Delaware. It's not the worst thing in the world if we don't get him. But currently we have the number 4 recruiting class. And there's something that I can I'm not sure who everything. I'm not sure who the freshman of the year. Second team, Patrick Russell made the All-American second team. If my memory's correct, oh no. Save my memories. Is the only freshman on the All-American. Good job. And give us both of you. Obviously, you saw the All-Conference. Think mostly us. Okay, but quick question though. Unless it was Seymour. Yeah. Which it was not. Oh wait, no, it was Banks. Derp. Yeah, that is just unlucky, man. The Brooklyn best player in your position just stole it from you. I mean, that just sucks. But personally, I thought these two should have been first team. They were the greatest, probably the greatest receivers I've ever had. When Connor had more touch, this is probably the best receiving core I've ever had in an NCAA game. We have 14 all first team, all conference first team guys. And two of them are freshmen. On the second team, do we have? We have 19 all conference guys. Is incredible. This was Blake Bortles. You can pause it if you want to see anyone in particular. just want to see. Six All-Americans. I think like conferences. Yeah, we are going all the time. No one cares about Marshall losing an attack. Notre Dame has like independent, so. Old Dominion had one? Good for them. Wow, Old Dominion had two? Did they win one on the first team? No, they did not. That's, that could be three, I don't know. No one cares about the Mac, really. So I'm just gonna speed through this. Akron did not have any. They had no all-state players. I mean, all-conference. Mountain West. Hey, do I remember you? I don't know. But that was my team before I did West Virginia. Two left ends got in. No right ends. Trash. Yeah, everyone knows they don't play defense. Kenneth Coker. Two left tackles, no right tackles, let me guess, yep. Well, yeah, left and right end. And the best conference, I believe, the SEC. Alabama is. 8 first team all conference players. LSU has, I think I only saw one. Yeah, LSU only has one. Wow, Johnny Manziel got the second team. Brad Griffin. Alabama has so many good players. And I know for like, well, obviously they're Alabama. And how many award winners did we get? Came in second for the Maxwell as a freshman. We got the Bedingfield. We got the O'Brien Award. Person I thought. No, he was not even in the running. Wow. The Mackey, which is like the best tight end, I guess. Wow. I think we got like 3 awards. Yeah, we got the best linebacker. The Thorpe Award. McDougal came in 4th. Oh, we only got 2? And who's playing in? I think it's like Georgia Tech. And yep, Kirk's going with Georgia Tech. Oh, jeez, they have 50. One pass. I don't think he got 13 sacks, though. Wait, let's see how I do. Got close. And he got close with tackles too. He definitely played 9 games. Honestly, this year was just incredible. Corey Hunter. Like, looking back, this year was just incredible. Honestly, I mean, we did have some problems with the quarterback play. You know, Russell had some turnover problems. Rutger also had some turnover. We had some turnover problems. But that's the biggest thing we're looking to crack down on next year. Eliminating the turnovers. We had an 1,000-yard rusher. freshman running back can repeat that. I thought this guy should have been up for the Biletnikoff award. I thought he should have. I feel like he earned it. Jackson might have been able to get the award for the tight end, I feel like. Then again, I do have a clear bias, so. Best offensive lineman, most pancakes eaten. Please say that's the most pancakes. Who's the worst alignment? Jason McNeil. And Derek Hadley were tied. Darren Day. I think we gave one guy like 3 picks. What was the longest field goal kicked? 56 yards by junior Joe Butler. Sucks that he's at such a bad school. With the highest percent. Freshman Clint Smith. Second was Brendan McFarland. Where does our guy rank? 78, yeah, he was an awful. I still know how he missed one extra point. Kicker. Yeah, probably because it never got into the end zone. Wow, Will Brown. 40% kicking. Do you know how hard that is to send him out there? Better have been blocked. Ah, no, he just... He attempted the second most extra point. Jeez, he had one big A. Well, they were only scoring touchdowns there. They were punting. Hank Ware. Longest Utah State Lamont Wells. 96 yards. I think that'll do for me. Bit of a different video. Back with the regular games. Back with the bowl game tomorrow. Hope y'all enjoy. Have a good one. And hey, you love league. Oh wait, no. Never mind, I have some stats to look at still. Second highest passer rating. He had the most completions. Fourth most attempts. The most yards. Third most picks. Most touchdowns thrown. He averaged the most yards, but he missed not even close. He's 30 completion percentage. He's a freshman too. He got sacked 26 times. Who led off college football in rushing? Jeez, Chris Steven. So you suck. Brown had, of course. I guess that makes sense. It's the academies. Except Army. Spurlock had the most rushing touchdowns. Yeah, I thought Spill. Spark had the most yards after contact. Tied for third in yard. He's tied for third again in broken tackles. Hey, Gerald Hurst, at least he not fumbled. Led the NCAA in receiving. Our boy Justin Wade's in third. John Bowers has the most drops. But overall, I feel like we not do too bad. I think this is it. I feel like we not do too bad. That for me. Hope you all enjoyed. Have a good one. And yeah, I just want to take a look at how many drops we had. Sevens. Four. Three. Hey, at least Taylor had zero drops. Smith also had zero drops. Yay. That's enough for me. Hope you enjoyed. Have a good one. And peace.